Good. I've got the address of Holmes's hideout. 6 Bucks Row.
Come, my lord, a little coin? Oi!
You shouldn't stay here, sir. There was a violent riot and it could start again at any time. Some people went crazy. They attacked our police carriage and stole the horse which was pulling it to eat it. Go home. It's dangerous here.
That's of no use.
You ain't from round here. You shouldn't stay here. It ain't healthy.
Well, here it is. It looks like a boarding house. I can't knock on all the doors. Holmes will hear me and escape. As I've the advantage of surprise, I'd better use it.
Oh, but I know you. You with the moustache. I met you back when Jack was cutting up all those girls around here. So you've come back to do some slumming.
Danny, you are no longer, you've given up the...
The game? Yes, my dear, I've given it up. Sorry, are you? I'm the manager of this boarding house now. I rent out rooms.
That is exactly why I am here. I'm looking for someone who...
He's not here.
You don't even know who I'm talking about.
Perhaps not, but he's not here anyway. You should understand that my tenants come here for peace and quiet. Quiet and discreet, my hotel is. Just like me. And I, Danny the Anvil, 11 times champion of male wrestling in Whitechapel, I guarantee their peace and quiet.
I really must insist. It's very important. Mrs. Anvil, I work for the government in the hygiene department, and your establishment...
Tough luck, ducky. I make my own law here.
I warn you, if you don't let me in, I will come back with the police. Think about it.
You're a grass as well. Cross this door and I'll knock your head off. Then we'll see whose side you're on.
Madam, I have found you at last. I'm one of your greatest admirers.
Are you having me on or what?
You are so very unique. I would like you to permit me to sketch your portrait.
My port? Portrait? What for?
What for? But to immortalize the champion that you are, of course. All the great wrestlers are doing it these days. Even Pudding, Nutcracker, Stomping Jenny.
Yeah, that's true. If those big cows can have theirs done, why not me?
The light here isn't good for artwork. Let me see some of your rooms. Perhaps we will find a better light, without disturbing your tenants, of course.
Don't worry about that. Most of them are out this time of day. And if they're not happy about it, I'll explain it to them gently, if you see what I mean.
I'm sure that they will understand at once.
Yeah, come on then.
Here would be perfect. A splendid place. Ah, I've just had a wonderful idea. Why don't I paint your portrait with you wearing your stage costume?
What?
Yes, I think it would be difficult for me to capture you correctly if you are dressed in your everyday clothes. They are too elegant.
Yeah, all right. I'm gonna be great. And it will remind me of the old days. Oh, but I left my costume with a pawnbroker so that I could buy some of that lovely pear-smelling perfume.
Yes, I remember. Very well, off you go. While I'm waiting, I shall concentrate and soak up the atmosphere here.
All right, but don't touch anything. The bloke that rents this room isn't very easy going. You'll have enough time. The pawnbroker's shop isn't close by.
What a mess. That's Holmes all right. Tobacco. And a lot of it. A sheet of blotting paper. A few files, books about criminal cases. The books Holmes usually reads. A pipe. And judging by the smell, Holmes has used it recently. Liquid reagents, a large quantity of it, the same as at Baker Street. Holmes uses it for cleaning objects before he analyzes them. Analyzing material. Analyzing material. A microscope. Holmes's coat and deerstalker. Dirty water. Holmes must have washed something here. These crystal glasses are magnificent. A violin. Holmes often plays. It helps him to think. But it's out of tune and the sound is horrible. Holmes must have become annoyed with it. That happens quite often. Each of these scores bears a piece of music by a different composer. Holmes wanted to learn them all. There's Mozart, Beethoven, Paganini. This pot is empty. A nice plant. I'm surprised that Holmes has taken care of it. I'm discovering new sides to his personality. Apparently, Holmes is packing his suitcase. This suitcase is closed with handcuffs, which in turn are attached to the sofa. These handcuffs are extremely solid. You need a code as well as a key to open them. Apparently, this suitcase holds something which Holmes believes to be important. I must open it. It could be the chance to find out the truth about his intentions. It's impossible to force the suitcase. It's armored. Holmes must have smoked his pipe while reading the newspaper. A pipe. And judging by the smell, Holmes has used it recently. As for the newspaper, it's only one page, with a curious article containing musical notes. This is what Holmes was reading without any doubt. Why? What do these notes mean? Even if the notes on the page are simple, this untuned violin isn't going to help me reproduce them. These crystal glasses might help me reproduce the notes in the newspaper. I know that music. It's Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. There, I found the score corresponding to Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. There is a strange stain on it. I must examine this stain more closely. This stain hides an inscription. It wasn't there by any accident. I need a reagent for cleaning the stain. Liquid reagents, a large quantity of it, the same as at Baker Street. Holmes uses it for cleaning objects before he analyzes them. This reagent is too strong. I'm afraid it will eat the paper away at the same time as the stain. I'll have to dilute it with water. Good. The reagent is weaker now. Have to clean all this up now. I need something. A sheet of blotting paper. A number. A number. These handcuffs are extremely solid. You need a code as well as a key to open them. Something is missing. Earth! Holmes must have washed his hands here. Therefore, he must have been searching in the soil. In this flat. But where? There's soil here. Let's do the same as Holmes. Search. A key. These handcuffs are extremely solid. You need a code as well as a key to open them. Excellent! I've found the key to the handcuffs. These handcuffs are Open. A train ticket for the London suburbs. For tonight. But if Holmes wishes to escape, surely he would travel further than that. Ah, there you are. I've got you.
Hey, what do you want?
That's enough. Take off that disguise.
What disguise?
I beg your pardon, young man.
In a moment, madam. Stop playing around. I've seen through you. You're going to have to give me some straight answers now.
I don't know who you are or what you want, but leave me alone now.
I think you are mistaken, young man.
Your ridiculous accent and your filthy clothes don't fool me, Holmes. And what on earth have you been eating? Your breath could kill an ox at 10 paces.
Right, that's it. You've got to get a thrashing of your life.
Calm down, Mr. Hooper. I think that this young man may have mistaken you for somebody else. He obviously does not have a good memory for faces.
On the contrary, madam, everything is crystal clear to me.
Really? Well, in that case, follow me, young man. I want to show you something.
What? But, madam, please, what are you...
Calm down, Watson. It's me.
Holmes?
You were almost brilliant, Watson, but once again, your last step was too wide. Take comfort in the fact that your finding this address was admirable enough.
Why are you out here if it's not for hiding from Scotland Yard? I demand an explanation.
You are in no position to demand anything.
I found you once, Holmes. You can be certain that if you give me the slip, I'll do it again. And next time, I'll return with Baines and his men.
I have absolutely no intention of leaving.
Truly? So what does this train ticket mean? It's a ticket for this evening.
You managed to open my suitcase?
Enough of your lies, Holmes.
As a matter of fact, then yes. I am leaving tonight.
We are leaving tonight. I'm not going to let you vanish again.
Very well. Follow me, if you so wish. But I should warn you that there is little chance of us both coming back alive.
I won't leave you for a second, and I accept the risk.